So I'm about to show you a gravity simulation, but before I do that, I want to set things up just a little bit here and tell you about the force of gravity. So I told you a little bit about it last time, but there's a couple things to know. First of all, the force of gravity always sort of behaves like mass 1 times mass 2 over distance squared. So what it means is if you have mass number 1 and mass number 2, and some distance between them, then what that means is you'll get F sub g, sort of exclamation point. In other words, you'll get a gravitational force. And so the law itself is always also known as an attractive force, in that F sub g always pulls things together. It never pushes things apart. So of course the example, you can just take any two masses here. You can take a pink mass like this that may be some pink planet or something like that, and you can take a brown mass like this, some other planet. And if you look at them, the pink planet has a mass m1. The brown planet has a mass m2, and of course there is a distance between them, sort of that connects the center to center distance. You would call that d. In this case here, then gravity would be sort of on, and m2 would be pulling m1 towards it like that, and m2 would be pulled towards m1 like that. They both sort of exert a mutual gravitational force on each other, and so yes, it would be true that if these two masses here, this mass and this mass, were just sort of sitting here, then it would be true that they would start moving towards each other. So after a while, the pink mass might be here and the brown mass might be here. Then after some more time went by, the pink mass might be here and the brown mass might be here, and they could actually collide. Now what happens in the case of the solar system is the reason why things don't keep colliding like that is because we have the sun right here in the center, and we have something like maybe a planet, say right here, like a nice brown planet sitting right here, and the planet, the gravity is towards the sun. In other words, the F sub g is attracted towards the sun, because again, the F sub g always wants to pull things together. So it is true that the sun in this case here would want to pull this mass towards it, and there could be a collision. The reason why that doesn't happen is because the planet is also moving in this direction here. We'll label this parameter v here for velocity, v for velocity. And because of this velocity here, that continually allows the planet to escape a direct path into the sun for some sort of a collision. So no matter where you would picture this planet going, say in a little while, it'll be over here, for example, here. So the brown planet would be right here. Yes, it would be true, the sun's gravity is still going to pull it inwards like that, but because it maintains its velocity this way here, it keeps moving in this path around the sun like that. And so what I'm describing for you here is the nature of where an orbit comes from. And so I'm about to run a simulation for you. I'll tell you sort of how Newton discovered all this and how it all comes together. But what an orbit is here is sort of a really careful balance between the gravitational force F sub g and v, the speed of the object. So of course this is the gravity here that would like to pull things together, and this, I guess here you could call it the object's speed. And as we'll find in the simulations I'm about to show you here, if you get just the right balance then, just the right balance between gravity and the object's speed, you can actually achieve an orbit. If you don't, you won't, but if you do, you do. And that's sort of the law of gravity that we need to understand the structure of the solar system. So apparently, by no doing certainly of my own here, the solar system has evolved into a case where there's a sun like this, and there's an orbit of Mercury right here, and an orbit of Venus right here, and an orbit of the Earth right here, and on it goes. You know the story now. all of them have an inwards pull due to the sun, but all of them also have their speed going sort of in this counterclockwise direction. There's a velocity of the Earth. There's a velocity of Venus. There's a velocity of Mercury. All of them have this speed, which keep them on, safely on their corresponding orbit, and they never crash into the sun because that balance has been achieved for all the planets. So, onwards with the simulation.